wrong anything. Nobody will help you because of fear of being targeted. And people have different coping strategies. They either, leave their community, go to other places. And so it doesn't only destroy people's lives, it also destroys communities that people have built over the time. And one of the things that has been, I think, like a flower blooming in the desert, is that the community survivors themselves are creating their own network of survivors, of healing, of thinking of how to resist this administration. And that's something that we are doing as part of the World March of Women continuously, because we fear that this violence will not only subvert our own alternatives building and construction, but we will basically create a generation wherein violence is the first key solution that they think of. And you know, it might be too late to rethink that the cycle of revictimization happens again. So it's sort of like a good experience, but also big challenge. But the good thing is that I think the crisis is creating a lot of opportunity for us to come together, to come stronger out of this situation. And at the center of it are the feminist movements in the Philippines. Thank you very much.